Good morning, my friends. Today we are going to study direct proportion. Now, when a quantity increases and another quantity increases at the same rate, this is known as direct proportion. Now, let's try to explain this one. It's very simple. Now, if you are going to buy one apple and it costs 30 cents. Now, when we are going to buy two apples, how much we need to pay or how much it costs? Now, it costs 2 multiplied 30, yani it means 60 cents. Now, if we are going to buy four apples, okay, four apples cost, now 4 multiplied 30, it will be 120 cents. Now, as you see here, increases number of the apple increases, and cost of the apple increases. Now they are increasing at the same rate. They are increasing at the same rate. Now this is called direct proportion. Now here, beside the direct proportion, there is also inverse proportion. Now it means when number of the apple increase, the cost of the apple will decrease. It means like this one. Now we are not going to study this part. We are going to study this part later. Now just we are going to learn that there is an inverse operation for direct proportion. It's inverse proportion. Now when two quantities in direct proportion are put into a table, multiplication pattern can be seen. Now here, let's write this one in a table. Now let me draw the table. Now let's say this is our table. Now what we have in this table: number of the apples, now the other one is cost of apples. Now let's say if we have two apples, let's multiply the number of the apples by 2, multiplied by 2, it will be 4 apples. Multiply 2 apples by multiplied 4 apples by 3. And from here to here multiplied by 5. Now 4 multiplied 3, it will be 12 apples. 2 apple multiplied by 5 apple, by 5, it will be 10 apples. Now let's go to the cost of the apples. For 2 apples, our cost will be 60 dinars. Sorry, 60 cents. Now if we are going to multiply this one by 2 to get 4, we need to multiply this one by 2 to get 120. Now this 4 multiplied by 3 to get 12 apple. Now this one we are going to multiply by 3 and to get 360 cents. Now it will be here multiplied by 2 also. From here to here multiplied by 3. From here to here we need to multiply by 5. Now 2 multiplied 5 is 10. 60 multiplied by 5, it will be 30 cents. Now we wrote this one as a multiplication table. Now multiplied by 30. Or we can do it in another for this one. Number of the apples. Okay. And cost of apples. Now, if we are going to start from 1, goes 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on and so forth. Now, this is look like using multiplication table at the same rate, it's going to increase. Will be 1 multiplied 3 is 30, 2 multiplied 30 is 60, 3 multiplied 30 is 90, okay, 3 multiplied 4 is 120, so 4 multiplied 30 120, 5 multiplied 30 150. Now 6 multiplied 30 180, and it will go in that form. Now this is the direct proportion. We used this one before as a multiplication table, as other things. Just we are going to recognize, or we are going to explain it in another way, in different way. Now as you see, now here we got this one with multiplication, but from here, starting from 310, dividing it by 30, we are going to get the inverse the things. It will be like this one. Let me erase the multiplication and let's go the things inversely. Now here, when we are going to divide the 10 by 5, we are going to get divided by 5, we are going to get 2. When we are going to 12 divided by 3, we are going to get 4. When 4 divided by 2, we are going to get 2. Or let's go from this side. If 300 divided by 5, we are going to get 60. If 360 divided by 3, we are going to get 120. If 120 divided by 2, we are going to get 60. Now, as you see, what we get with multiplication, inversely, doing division, we are going to get the beginning numbers. Okay, here after this one we are going to see how we are going to make a graph with direct proportion. Now for this one, let's draw a graph, XY coordinate system. Now Now, as you see, this is 0. Now, let's go. The number of the apples will be here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 apples. Here, number of apples. Now, here will be cost. Cost will be in cents. Now it will go 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, 300, and 350. Let me write 50, 100, 150, 200, 250, 300, and 350. Now here 1 apple, 2 apple, 3 apple, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 apples, and it goes in this form. Now here, let's say 2 apple will cost, here 2 apple will cost how many dinars? 60. It's here. Now let's say 4 apple will cost 120. It's 4 apple, 120. It's here. Now 10 apple will be 300. It's 10 apple will be 300. Now, if you are going to sketch these values, they will be on a line, and this line will be okay. Now this must be a little bit up here, and this is here. Now with this one, we are going to see our graph. Now our graph passed through 0.0. Now we can say this one, all direct proportion graphs pass through 0.0 and 0. Now this is our graph. Here we can find any other information using it. For example, if we have five apples, how much they are going to cost? It will be like this one. Now this will be for any value. Or when you are going to pay 200 or 300, or for example 330, how many apples are you going to get? You can find it from here. Let's say if you are going to pay 210 tens and cents, you will get 7 apples. Now this is our graph. And how we are going to use, you know, mostly that one. And let's go our examples now. Now, our first example is 3 oranges cost 81 cents. How much do 7 oranges cost? Now, let me erase the board. Now our example says us, okay, 3 oranges cost 81 cents. How much do 7 oranges cost? Let's write number of orange. Number of orange. Okay, it's 8. Sorry, it's 3 oranges. Now cost of orange, cost of the orange will be 81 cents. Now question is, how much do 7 oranges cost? 7 oranges cost how much? Now what we need to do, we need to find how much cost one orange. Let's say cost of one orange. Now we are going to use this one, okay, 3, okay, 81. 3 multiplied, which number is 81? We can find it. 81 divided by 3 and the result will be 27. Now cost of one orange will be, cost of one orange will be 27. Now we can find how much cost 7 orange. For this one we are going to multiply 7 multiply 27. Now let's go here, the answer will be 7 multiply 27. Now if you are going to multiply them, we are going to get 189 as a result. 189 will be the result. Then 7 oranges cost 189 cents. Now let's go to second example. The second example is on the screen. Now the second example is, fill in the missing numbers if x and y are directly proportional to each other. Now let me draw the table here. X and y is here. Now here we have 4, 10, now 7, and we don't know here. And let's go to the next one. Here question mark, here we have 35. Now they have a direct proportion. Here as you see the result. As you will see, the result can be decimal numbers. Numbers can be decimal, no problem here. Numbers can be decimal. There is no any problem. Now using the direct proportion here, we are going to find 10 divided by 4 and we are going to find the multiple here. It will be equal to 2.5 is multiple. Now it means by which number are we going to multiply the things. Now let's go on. If we found 2.5 as a multiple, then 7 we need to multiply it by 2.5. Now let's go. 7 need to multiply it by 2.5. Now here the result will be 17.5. Now we solve this one. Instead of unknown, there will be 17.5. Instead of the question mark will be 17.5. What about here? Now there is, the multiple is not changing. Okay, we are going to divide it now to go back here. Now let's go on. 35 we need to divide by 2.5. What is the result here? Here the result will be 14. Now let's do it here. Here 35 divided by 2.5. And the result will be 14. 14 is answer here. Now let's go on. Let's go to our next example. Now our next example is on the screen. While you are reading, I am going to erase the board. Now, a green paint is a mixture of yellow and blue paint in the ratio 5:2. If 28 liters of yellow paint are used, how many liters of blue paint are needed to make the green paint? Now, here also we need to find the multiple here. Let's go. Let's write yellow paint. And the ratio is 5, and the blue paint and the ratio here 2. Now question is this one: if they used 28 liters for yellow paint, how many liters for blue paint they need to use? Now for this one, let's find the multiple here. To find the multiple here, we are going to divide 5 by 2. Sorry, 2 divided by 5. Now it will be 2 divided by 5. Now the division will be 0.4. The multiple will be here 0.4. This is the multiple. Now if we have 28, we need to multiply it by 0.4 to get the result. To get how many liter blue paint they needed. Now let's go on 28. Multiplied by 0.4 and the result will be 11.2. Now if they are going to use 28 liter yellow paint, they need 11.2 blue paint for this one. Now with this one today we finish our lesson. Now let's see our homework. Now today homework, page 214, questions from 1 to 9. Now tomorrow there will be no lessons because you are going to solve your consolidation. Second homework, page 215 and page 216, consolidation. Solve the questions. If you have any questions, send me email. See you on next lesson, inshallah.